Beatrice had any professional training before?
No.
Okay. So have you ever worked on what's called an emergency U-turn?
No.
Get out of there. Okay. So I'm going to ask you just to turn over here. Okay. Okay, Beatrice. She's on the hot dogs. I'm going to ask you just to take 3 or 4 steps towards that cone and then quickly turn and walk back this way. Okay? Okay, I think we could call that not smooth. All right. So the point of an emergency U-turn, there could actually be a lot of reasons that you would teach this. If she were a reactive dog that does a lot of barking and lunging at other dogs on leash, as we're working on desensitization and counter-conditioning to passing other dogs, we don't want to keep putting the dog in the situation where she's going to react. So I want to get a U-turn and get her out of the situation until we're ready to start passing dogs again. Another reason I use it with my own dogs is just if there's an off-leash dog up there, or the school bus just let out, or just a situation that might make my dog uncomfortable, I can just turn and safely get her out of that situation and walk the other way as well. All right? So I'll grab her from you. Hi. And I'm going to spend the first few minutes teaching a hand target. Touch. Good. Luckily, she seems extremely food motivated, so this won't take long at all. Touch. Good. So I'm just putting a treat in my fist. Touch. And then when she bumps my fist with her nose, it makes my fist open up and she gets the treat. Touch. And I'm working on it forward and backward. Touch. Good girl. You want to try?
Sure.
So treat in your fist. Pull the fist out and say touch, moving in one direction or the other. This is touch. Touch. This is. She's got hot dogs too. Good, try one more time. This is touch. Okay. I think we're good to go on that because she is following the food. So I'm going to try to go corner to corner. I guess it's all the same distance, just so I can take a few steps. And I'm going to lure her forward, turn, keep luring, and then touch to get her to follow me. Okay, so I'm just going to work on that a couple times. Inches. Turn, touch. Good. I'm going to throw the word turn in. She doesn't know what it means. But then when she comes to touch, she will be doing the turn, so I'm naming it.
3 minutes.
Thank you. Let's go. Turn, touch, good girl. Good. Do one more and then hand her over to you. So I could say, let's go. I don't have to. I'm gonna lure her forward, say turn, turn, say touch. She's doing great. Let's go. So take a minute, go back to the start. Take a minute to show her that you have food, that you're working with her now. You could even do a touch, touch to get her warmed up. Let's go. Okay. So here, come back to the start. If she's not following your hand, don't keep walking. So get her nose right at your hand. Good. Perfect. Turn. Touch. Touch. Yes. Perfect. Try that again. And so get her all set up. She's facing the wrong way. Take a minute. Good. Let's go. Turn. Touch. Yeah. Good girl. And this time, you turn and walk in the right direction, too. So instead of backing up, see if you can get up here, turn, and you're actually walking forward like this with your hand going behind you. Turn. Touch. Yes. Perfect. Questions? I don't think so.
30 seconds.
Beatrice, you did so good.